When we're beginning our 7 weeks of our 3 days Esther fast, the Lord gave us a particular instruction to reach out to the less privileged. And those people were the people from Kizzi. That name Kizzi is named after poor. When these people do it because they do not have enough money to pay for the toilet facilities, they throw it in the polythene bags. That is why it is named after that name, Kizzi. So during that time, as people were fasting, they had to bring foodstuffs that they would have eaten in the 21 days of their 7 weeks of the 3 days Esther fast. And the instruction was to bring new clothes, new things for the less privileged. This was a form of wishing them Merry Christmas. So on the 16th of December, we happened to have taken Merry Christmas to them. Those people are really going through a challenging life. We happen to have visited different houses of the residents. These people who stay in this place are basically Karimajong. They rent the ground and they construct their different structures. Some are made out of sacks, others are made out of mud. And all the houses that we entered never had mattresses or beds. Just someone putting a sack down and they sleep. And in those houses they sleep around between 6 to 25 people. Just imagine, they rent the ground at 50,000 a month. And about the food they eat, some of them have got the opportunity of working in different places. Some ladies go to a winnow and they sweep those places where they unload beans from, so they are able to get some beans. But all those beans are mixed up of beans of different shades, and they come back, eat those beans and sell to the rest. So the community that they sell to is their very community. Others work in roofers by cleaning them, and they're given animal fat. Just there was an example of this lady was busy roasting animal fat. She was frying the animal fat for oil to come out. When I asked her, she told me she was going to use it. She was going to use it for her meal. She was just going to add paste and eat with ugali, just like that. They hardly have food. I think food there is by faith. This particular house where there was dressed chicken, but it didn't look fine. It didn't look fresh. They just like roasted it a little. And when I inquired, I asked, where did they get this chicken from? The chicken was given to them from a winnow. It was dead.
Yeah. So this is a dead chicken that they're
dead going chicken.
To
eat? Once they go to the market, they get people when they are who are selling chickens. Mm. So those chickens who are dead, they give them.
Some of the men make mouse traps. That's their source of income. And they make sigiris that are made out of wires, of which you can't put these sigiris in the modern world. They are really struggling that they do not have food to eat at times. So life in that place is so terrible. They have to pay for their waters. That's why you see some are dirty. They cannot bathe every day like the normal people, because they have to buy water. The cost of living in the place is high, being that they have to pay ground rent of 50,000 a month. The security for ladies in that place is not that good. Most of the girls are raped, and at times they even fear to report. In some cases, they take on the cases and the culprits end up being put behind bars. But most times, the ladies fear to report about the rape cases. And rape is inevitable in that place because they hardly have doors. Someone can easily enter into their houses and do anything to them. And about the education system, most of the young girls or boys, the children in the place, have not gone to school. Some, the minority, come on the street and beg, and others just stay in the place like that without going to school. And they have to eat food, they have to be taken care of, and yet they have no one to take them back to school. This is what we plan to do in the next festive season, upcoming projects. Would like to reach out to these people by giving them mattresses and beddings. And another thing is, these children need to be taken back to school, they've never gone to school. The adults need to go for tertiary education. They need to find what to do with their hands. That is how we want to reach out to these people, to put them back onto their feet. At least teach them the basics. Teach them how to read, teach them how to write.
for giving to the Lord. I have a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. Then another man stood before you and said, remember the time a missionary came to your church. His pictures made you cry. You didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave, and that's why I'm here today. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave.
I just want to thank all the partners, friends, members and listeners of Beautiful Ashes, because without you, this Christmas donation to the less privileged would not have been successful. You, when we called you to give, you gave bountifully. You gave shoes, you gave clothing, you gave foodstuffs. Thank you so much. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord increase you. May you multiply and replenish in Jesus' mighty name.